guys, welcome back. This is Sean from Play by Pause. It's 2021 and if a filmmaker, it's likely that you own a gimbal. So do I. I own my very first gimbal since 2016 and I love it since then. Let me show you my very first gimbal. So this is my very first gimbal. This is a Jin Crane version 1. It's a very small, lightweight gimbal and I love it a lot. But I replaced it with my Jin Crane 2 because it kind of broken. But anyway, as a content creators and filmmakers, I always find a way to improve my gimbal skill. And one of the things that I learned throughout this journey is to choose the correct or right lens on a gimbal. So today's topic, I'm going to talk about prime lenses versus zoom lenses on a gimbal setup. I know this is going to be a controversial topic, but instead of me telling you which is the best, I'm going to share you my own opinions based on my personal experience and thoughts on which lens to choose and why. These are the lenses that I use for my gimbal setup. I love all of them and they serve different purposes and scenarios. One of the things that I like prime lens over zoom lens is lightweight. For example, this 50mm f2.5G lens weighs only 170 grams, which is crazy lightweight. Even the heaviest prime on the table itself still weighs lesser compared to the Sony G Master 24-70 f2.8. I know you might be saying that, but Sean, this covers 24-70, and you're right. But like I mentioned, I always prefer a small, lighter setups. In general, smaller lenses allow smoother movements because it takes out some of the micro movements while filming on a gimbal. Another thing with lighter setup is the lighter the rigs, the easier it is to hold for a longer period of time. I can hold this prime lens throughout the days until the gimbal's battery dies. Another thing that I prefer primes over zoom is it's easier and safer to balance on a gimbal. The issue with zoom lenses on a gimbal is the problem of shifting balance point when you're changing your focal length. Even though it wouldn't directly affect anything while filming, eventually it will damage the gimbal motors due to the unbalanced setups. Another thing to point out is you might accidentally scratch the front parts of the lens if your camera falls forwards unsupervised when you turn off the gimbal. So something to keep in mind if you're using a zoom lens. Next, prime lenses are easier to balance and more compatible with most of the gimbal in the market. You can pick up a smaller gimbal such as the Jim Weibo S, Weibo S2, the DJI Ronin SC2, which carry a lesser payload, but they are smaller. As you can see, I'm using the Sony 40mm f2.5 on my Jin Crane version 1, which is very lightweight. And another thing is I can easily switch the lens between 40mm to 24mm without much adjustments, since most of the time, the prime lenses are smaller and you don't even need to rebalance the gimbal. The next reason to use the primes is generally, they perform better than zoom. Prime lenses normally have a lower apertures. The most of the prime lenses have aperture of f1.8. The Jin Master series even go as low as f1.2, which creates some amazing bokeh and they perform way better in low lights. Whereas the zoom lenses, the high-end zoom lenses, only goes down to f2.8. It might not sound a lot, but it can be 1 to 2 stops above the f1.8 or f1.2. Next debate might not be a huge deal anymore, which is sharpness. The reason why I'm not going to make a big fuss on it is because zoom lenses have improved a lot in recent years. There used to be a wide gap between prime and zoom, but thanks to modern technology, zoom lenses are closing the gap more than we think. Sometimes I couldn't even tell the difference between prime and zoom. So why I will pick zoom over primes? The main reason I will pick zoom over prime, obviously I need the multiple focal range without changing lenses. Personally, I think zoom lens is a perfect run and gun lens for a small project or one-man projects because you wouldn't need to bring extra lens or change lenses or even rebalance your gimbals. For example, a Sony 24-70 basically covers most of focal lengths, practically you would use for most projects such as an event where you're running around and you need to cover varying focal views in an uncontrollable circumstance. Some tips when you're picking up your zoom lens, get a constant aperture. I would suggest to get at least f2.8 because you wouldn't want to change your exposure countlessly when you're changing the focal length. Next up is price. This isn't related to the topic of which lens works better on gimbals, but I thought it will be one of the factors when you are planning to get a lens in your filmmaking journey. This can be a very tricky answer because you can't really compare one to one since zoom lens covers multiple focal range. For example, a Sony 24 to 70 would cost lesser when it compares to a combination of 24, 40, 50, and an 85. In that case, it really depends on your job requirements and your personal shooting styles. For example, if you are a sport photographer or videographers, and you don't really need a low aperture, then I would highly suggest zoom lenses because I believe they work better compared to prime. Even though zoom lenses give me a lot of versatility and budget friendlier, but honestly, 80% of the time, I will still pick prime over zooms because most of the time I will film in a team and we will have planned beforehand. For example, in a commercial shoot, we will have sufficient time to use the best lens we have. And if it's a wedding project, we film in a team and normally we use different focal lengths to tell a better story. And one of the most important factors of using prime lens on a wedding project is, imagine using Sony 24-70 on a gimbal for 6 to 8 hours. I'm pretty sure it will kill my arms. Anyway, all this info are based on gimbal use only. If you are using a monopod or handheld, then it will be a different story. So there's definitely time and place where zoom lenses are totally the option there is. I hope this video helps you to understand why 80% of the time I will use prime over zooms. And you must understand, prime lens aren't the best either. There's definitely time and place for these two lenses and you should figure out which works better for you and fits you. Let me know in the comment section below on which lens works better for you on a gimbal. And until next time, create learn and have fun. I'll see you guys in the next video.